Good evening.
A tough game. We lost a tough game. Yeah, a lot of positives and negatives. A game that is very competitive from the beginning to the end. Yeah, I think we could have played until tomorrow without scoring. You know, I thought we missed a lot in FNB, where we missed about 6-7 chances. But this thing again comes back. We missed again today. We missed a lot of goals. Yeah, evenly balanced team game. A game that doesn't have a lot of free flow, obviously, because it's a big game. You know, yeah, good attendance, and it went well in terms of the way it expected, the way it came out. I think we did well with our preparations to the game, and it came out as expected. Just unfortunate that we missed a lot of chances. Yeah, that's it.
Okay, you know the ground rules, your name, and introduce yourself with a question. You're the first one.
Coach, Tisetso here from Football Conversations. Coach, obviously not the result that you wanted, but you've been involved in numerous title races, so obviously you'll know what to fix there. I just want to know, in your view of the game, which part of the team do you think let the other part of the team down? Was it the defense that let the team down, or was it the attack?
No, the defense was good. The defense was good. Can't blame Madisha, Musa. They played well. Anela was one of the best players we have. He showed maturity. So, if I answer your question, the attack did not complete the chances. So, probably we can say that.
Okay. Let's hear you, Tsepo.
The coach, Tsepo from ENC. You did say before the match that this is not a title decider. Whether you lose to Chiefs or
not. Of course.
The Chiefs P2 at home, I'm sure
you
must be worried. First loss?
No, not worried. Upset, of course. I'm not happy that we lost, but I'm not unhappy with the manner in which the players fought to win the match. You must accept the way the things are. They tried. They tried to win. They tried to score. But we could play until tomorrow, eh? They missed a lot. So I'm upset with the results, yes, of course. I mean, you know me, I don't want to lose. But I must also accept that that we did not score. That's why we did not win, you know. I thought maybe even one goal, even if there's 10 minutes left, I thought we could come back, you know. But we did not. The team played well.
Okay.
Maskepe from Bada. Apart from your team not scoring and Chiefs managing to score those two goals, where would you say they were better than your side today? Where would you say you probably, other than just not scoring?
Let's be honest. What did Kennedy do today? Unless you're emotional on the game. Kennedy, nothing. There's nothing that he did, let's be honest. I mean, and by the way, the score is an offside goal. Eh? They benefited again. The first goal is offside. Yes, it's offside. So, what's new here? What's new? We lost again, the referees made a mistake, the linesman on the line is offside. So, is there anything different before this match and after the match? It's the same. It's the same song. So what are we talking here? They benefited again from the referee's mistakes. The second goal is a goal. No doubt about it. But you play under stress, you play under pressure because you have to equalize. You're going to get caught somewhere, you know. You play under stress. It's not a normal game. There you are. So what else do we talk about Kaizer Chiefs? The way it is, it doesn't help.
Okay, the gentleman behind you, Muscat.
Kosi here from Football Conversations. Coach, in terms of Temba Zwane, what's the latest in terms of his condition, and also how much did you miss him today in terms of we all know what type of a player it is.
Yeah.
Do you think he could have made that difference today?
Yeah, Mshishi always find a way out to do something. He's a player who sorts himself out, who, especially on a game like this, we needed somebody to help us, Serino, because him and Serino, they combined well. So that's when you miss him a little bit. To be honest, in terms of Dennis Onyango, for this game, no. Kennedy didn't do nothing, to be honest. Kennedy did well. But, yeah, you miss Mshishi. But it's a story I told you. The game of Highlands is a thorn in the flesh. The game of Highlands of playing Wednesday, and you have Chiefs on Sunday, when Chiefs, the last time they played was on the weekend. You know, it's a hard game that we played against Highlands. And we had to run until the 93rd minute to win the match. We fought hard to win the match. So it comes with the after effects. You know, so it's part of it. When you play Highlands on Wednesday, you play a well-rested team that we have played almost seven games that they haven't played. They will have a little bit of more energy, to be honest. It's part of it. It's part of our lives. If we don't want to be in this position like this, so we should be out of top eight. We should not even win play CAF. So it's the price you pay when you're an ambitious club like Sundowns.
Right. And then after him.
Coach, just football-wise, Chiefs, I think you got 4 points from them. Last season, what's the difference between the Chiefs of last season, as you are planning for them coming to this game, the official game, what is the difference between the Chiefs of last season and this season? And also, if you can just touch on Afonso, I saw when you introduced him, the presence that he was giving in the box, the problems that he was giving the center backs. Is this the type of a player that would also be more effective in the Champions League?
Yeah, we need that kind of a player. He's got an input. He also missed an opportunity, and you can feel his presence over there. He's a bull in the box, and he knows how to play football. I mean, 4 games, 3 goals, not bad, eh? So, yeah. On the difference of Kaizer Chiefs, I think they've got more spirit now. They've got more fight. They pack a good fight, we have to be honest. Of course, they've got an good influence of the coach, who is tough, who wants to win. They're more willing to, more stronger than last year. That's the difference. And the other difference is they didn't have the referees who makes mistakes last year to the referees who make them benefit this year. They know it's a fact. The first goal, offside. Mazulu, if they allow the 2 goals, the lock changes. So it is the way it is. That's the difference. You get scared. You say, when is this thing finishing? When is this? Is this going to go? Is it a spiral or what? I mean, really, is this going to stop? Eh? I mean, this thing must stop. Eh? I mean, where are we going? So we have to look at them again next week. You'd say, I want to see if referees will make mistake against Pirates. Let's see. Something has to give in now, eh? No, something has to give in. No. I don't know if Pirates supporters will allow it. No, something has to give in. No, you can't win every day by referees' mistakes. Must give, must stop. It's enough. We've seen it before, but now it's worse. It's a series. You know, it's okay once there and then Robert Sanya and Wabuavie. But it's a series. I mean, really. Is it a football ref mess or what? I mean, this team. Excuse me.
Okay.
Coach, out of the things that you mentioned, you've spoken about the referees, you've spoken about Chiefs having fight, you've spoken about your players.
And we must never confuse the fight and the will of the team to the mistakes of the referees.
Yeah.
Okay? Because it will look like maybe I'm discrediting them that they don't have a fight or whatever. No, they have a fight. I mean, you saw them. They come back from 1-0, they come back 2-1. I mean, we have to give them credit. But also, there's an angel here. You have to win now. You complete.
With those two things, coach, and also maybe the fixture from your side of things having played three games in, 6 days, one of those three factors would you say played the biggest role in your loss today?
Today?
Yeah.
The two. Where we lost Mshishi because of the game. Because Mshishi is very important. It's like losing Gaston. That one. And the factor of benefiting.
Okay.
Coach, based on your answer there of certain teams benefiting.
Not certain teams, one team. Can you rephrase? One team. No, don't be diplomatic. I hit straight, my friend. I don't have time to go around. No, me, I just talk straight. You talk to me straight. I don't care. Don't want to be going around circles. No, straight.
Based on your opponents today, coach, would you welcome, and it's more of an administrative issue, but would you welcome the introduction of VAR tomorrow by the PSA?
First, spray. Second, goal line technology. Third is the communication. Today there was communication. When you played Amazulu, there was no communication. Okay? Then you go to VAR. Let's crawl, then we can walk. Okay? Fourth one, the last one, the fourth or the fifth, I don't know what is it, is praying. We need a lot of praying when you play this team. That they must never benefit again. So it's the many factors. It's five. So is the odds against you to win, really? Really, really, you have to do, I don't know.
Okay.
But in terms of the fouls, the referee was good. Okay? Cape Town City, the fouls were let go. That's why Ben is still crying. In terms of fouls, Victor was good. He gave everybody the yellow cards that he deserves. Kekana kicked Kama, deserved a yellow card, probably a red. Okay? Same as Katsande and all that. You know? We have to say the positives also. Okay? The referee was good today. The assistant referee on the other side. And the assistant referee who's this side, I was very much scared of him. Because when Chiefs played SuperSport United, what's his name, the right center back of Chiefs? The white boy? Passed the half ball to the goalkeeper. Krobla went for the goalkeeper. They pulled Krobla down. It was a foul against Krobla. 1v1 with the goalkeeper. And it was this assistant referee was on the side. So I told him, I said, you must never do that again today. So I know them all. And they come back. No, we know them. I mean, it's a story. It's the same. It's the thing. Remember, I also want to have this. My last eight games of the league. No. I need people to make mistakes against other people. Then I benefit. I'm waiting. My last eight games, probably it will go like that. And you can say that I also benefited, yes. I will say yes. When I benefit, I'll tell you yes, I benefit. I will never say, if I benefited, I will say I benefited. Why not?
Your question, sir.
Coach, I'm Eugene from Marbella FM. When you started, you said that there was a lot of positives and negatives. Can you elaborate a bit on the positives?
Creating of opportunities. The challenges is not taking them. Those are your negatives and your positives. Should be done.
Okay, guys, I think...
Okay, give him a chance.
You after him or him after you?
Yeah, two of them, it's okay. Okay. Yeah.
Special yeah. 405.
Okay.
Yeah?
And 405.
Okay.
Okay, we have four.
Regarding Alimenta, the Alimenta of last 97, there's a big difference. What happened?
Well... Would be nice for you to ask him, yeah? But he had a very good preseason, eh? And he's fighting, he's trying. Little bit unlucky, not getting goals as he's supposed to get. for the amount of energy and input he puts. I think he needs a little bit 2-3 goals, you know what I'm trying to say? Like Temba. Temba's on the scores free scoring. So that's what he needs. But I think maybe we give him enough opportunities to play, and maybe we're supporting him with confidence, but also he's fighting. He's running, he's hard running, you know? The boy tries, eh? Yeah.
That's good.
No, I was saying you can give those with another.
Yeah, give.
Thanks. Coach, you talked about how they're different. Do you think now it sets the league, trying to win the league this season, whoever's going for it is going to be a little bit much that tricky? And from the press box at halftime, we're able to squash the heated moment that happened with Ernst Middendorp, because we could see that.
No, it was not with me. We were talking to the assistant referee. It was not me and him. No, I'm being serious. We never exchanged words.
He said that too, eh?
Yeah.
What did he say? Did he say I spoke to him?
He said you didn't.
No, I don't speak to Ernst Middendorp. Give me a chance. I have to talk also. I can we have a conversation. When he speaks against Super Sport at Thomas Mlambo's show, when he speaks, I spoke. When he won against Benny, he put the honorable what? I tell him about his tourism that he's been doing for the whole part of football, 7 years tourism that he did, and of how he benefits, you know. So I will tell him, I don't start, but I will give back. I'll never allow him to say anything because I've got more. I can drop them. Every day he speaks, I will drop them. You know, I've got a lot against him. That referees, what, he was there at PSL. You remember when he said PSL is against him? I have 4 accounts. And then he realizes, no, this is too much. Let me leave. Okay, we stay when we don't benefit. Né? So he left. So it's if he gives me a give back, you know the story. I'll never let you go. You know? Because why? I stand for myself. I speak. Why not? I don't speak. I don't hold back because, hey, maybe I'm killing my chances of coaching another team next year or something. No. My heart is here. I fight. When I fight, I fight. I don't care who I fight against. For my team, I fight. So I don't create opportunities or, hey, maybe I said too much against this team and then maybe I cannot never get a job. Excuse me. I don't play in that space. I roll my heart in the sleeves and I fight. When I fight, I fight. Okay? And we're going to fight for the PSL, for the league. Okay? We fought for the league with them before and then they gave way. And then came Vets and then they gave way. Came Pirates for the last 2 years. They gave way. So we fight again. But the common denominator is us fighting for the league for the last 6 years. Second twice, 4 times we won it. So you must have endurance you want to fight with us. Ne? Must go 6 years. We are here. One match doesn't mean anything. So did I answer you 4 or 5?
Yes.
Thank you, brother Alex. We're done.